a language, a music, an utterance within, a view about. Circumventilation of hypercritical counterfacts, nowhere metabounded, without utterance within, without view about. What is there to be onto, logically or ontologically, without benefit of philosophistry? What is about is also of, also is. Within. Also ever specious, meta-present world now, somewhere, meta-bounded nowhere, utterance within, nascendant, sempiternal being, about to be of, coming, contained, elapsing, incontinent, unshaded, or texturous, unexterpreted here place, anytime immemorial, a leading edge of a vanishing act, uncatalogued hordes of phenomenal finds, all comprehended within, without benefit of theory, all systems gone without a trace, not a language, not a music, within sound or sight, not a thing for a thing to be, nor anything left over to do. Utterance within view, about, nowhere meta-bounded without, view within utterance about. From what's on ever speciously itself manifested, a now irretrievable attachment within view of utterance about, then now itself irretrievable, then now irretrievably itself, then itself retrievable now, as was, in specious increments, attaching what there was, attaching to what there was, attaching what there was to what there was, nowhere metabounded, somewhere, utterance within of a view about. In a language, in a music, within a world now irreducibly reshaded, view within utterance of, nowhere metabounded, unconditional counterfact of meta-presentable species. Here begins attaching. In specious increments, then to now, as now of then, reshadowed, as then of now, as here of there, re-echoed, as there of here, as nowhere emerging, as somewhere, begins, impending, meta-bounded nowhere, from somewhere an utterance within, not yet about or of, not yet still, still unactualized counterfact, subtextually pre-articulate, just now elapsing along a line of least demarcation, self-determining a still formative start feeling, something extending somewhere, somewhere terminating nowhere. What there is, commencing here, in specious increments attaching, the shaping spans of singularity retrieved, plurally compounded as unitarily infused, endlessly recalled, to the brink of awareness, ever filling the void of unpreoccupied space, always following nowhere, without benefit of geography, along the untraveled auguries of undelimited expectation, now unfolding itself beyond its time, begins. Somewhere, nascendant, sempiternal, within world now, of utterance within, to inceive recasting the sharpened shadows of here now, sempiternal, of utterance unframed, resounding the gathering echoes itself reflected as matter of view of now some appreciable moment, determined to be, in particular, sound, in extremity, simple, incarnate as world now nascended within, metamorph of there then rescinded without, in simp external here space reimagined to order, inflicting awarehood received unfiltered, undeviate, unbounded at the thresholds of nascendence simp eternal, now intending itself undefiled as utterance without humming, howling, saying, singing, discerning, detaching, retrieving, without remembering, without relating, without recounting, without begins. From a first indexed moment to form members in thick and fastening prefusion, multiplied in specious increments, conforming to now. From a first indexed moment, unspools a time scene, evolves a place of conjunction attached, ever returning to air now again and again, refluxes on tight warp extended, omnipresent with intimate hindsense, speciously. From a first indexed moment, warps across a flickering time scene, unspooled increment by lingering increment, utterance conjoining with utterance to frame. In creaturing each new, newly multiplied member, and all as well. Irreducibly metabounded here now, repleting, for clarity's sake, whatever has been beclogging and metaform effusion without. Backcumulating in multiform deflection within, whatever across a time scene, tight warped, the flicker thickening multiprescient now, the ur-now of omni-conjunction fast, forever attaching has been unspooling from a first indexed moment to now. A voice is heard, wrapped in utterance, inscribing in resonance a never-emptying new space, berimmed along the unsilent warp of a time scene outspread. A voice, framed in somewhere, filtering through a fine-meshed time screen, is heard, draped in reverberance past, diffused, in echoing shimmer gone, bathing in afterglow lost, in incipience lapsed, with touches of depth, reliving a long-dead, unrememberable, shadowless no-world, with shades of dimension backgrounding echo, with breath strokes drawing new from a refractory void, otherhood and selfness elicited in unison. A voice is heard, becoming a language, becoming a music, becoming a world now refracted in resonance. Within a world, simp eternal, nascendant, within, becoming awareness and utterance as one and only now, begins. As a time scene unspools across populously creatured, densely warped ridges, astride the slithering torrents of utterance unleashed, there recalls something. Then, lingering still in its own place, somewhere between that old upstart moment first indexed, somewhere between then and now, by another moment somehow recalled before, only increments, onflowing torrent, perhaps, slightly tilts, warp bridging time scene, perhaps membering, perhaps creaturing, before now, somehow, there calls anew, arises, confronting, now across the rigid, warped time space between then and now, confronted, each by the other, reverberant across the span, something and another now and then, or sooner and later, somewhere between the first and most, and only moment till now indexed, at all since then became incremented into utterance. Warped into time scene, spread out, filtered through, depthed, dimensioned, ridged, increatured, membered, and now there recalls first, confronts the other, across reverberant space, within, between the old returns, recalled, across another, indexed, as each and both confront within reverberant time or space, between at first unqualified, except as each, and other confronted, elicit across reverberant span of scene, an echo of self or other, reverberant within the scene of sound or glow, referring between, before, the old refrains, the new returns across the span of space or time, between referring to quality, each recalling the other, refers within to index, either first confronting both, and now the moment at once detaches, confronted no more, returns to place, relocated somewhere between the moments, on flowing within the spaces, expanding, interning, on course deflected, selfness, qualified, conferred by otherhood, attached, touched by reference, without by reverberance, infused by confronting. Recalled between the place, somehow there, lingering beyond somewhere, at first indexed last moment, again the time scene begins. To be a language, now. To be a music, now. To be an utterance within, now. To be within a world now, irreducibly reshaded. To be an image of now. To be meta-bounded nowhere. To be of. To be about. To be now. To be is to mean.
stars above you. Remember, remember, we found a lonely spot, and after I learned to
Okay, so that's got it together. So you couldn't pry it apart with a $10 toothpick. So maybe it's the payoff on all the purple burple's been let off around here lately. Not that I'm naming any names, you understand, but let's face it, you know what I mean. With the windows shut and all, hard to feature all that jive in one sitting. Well, all that's ancient history now anyway, ever since old man Berlin made the scene. Really cut the mustard way back in 25, in the days before anyone knew what an 8-track mixer was from a one-horse shay. I bet they hadn't even invented the running board yet. Too busy winding up all the good old Victrola to spin them Caruso platters on. And all that time, old man B went on squeezing off chart busters, riffing on any old tatty thing that was going on down in the street between the Statue of Liberty and the Russian front. Like, he's not like I'm grooving on nostalgia or any kick like that, you dig? It's strictly, man, that this cat's meow just sets my table like nobody's business. Know what I mean? Really says it all. And I don't mean any of that SM radio, easy listening music jive crapola neither. What I mean is the whole works. Like on that track, the long-haired gin up front just blew. The reel laying it out, straight McCoy, complete with Canary and Sideman, doing their thing like it's 11:45 and there's no tomorrow. Don't ask me how he gets it to cook like that. You wouldn't take a flyer with a wooden nickel at a sucker bait odds on the chance of one of these ditties making the cut with nothing up front but some Mickey Mouse marshmallow cornballing lyrics and some honky-tonk man tonking his tinfoil tune that wouldn't have got Tchaikovsky past the doorman at the Manhattan School of Music. Hey, it's like simply unreal what comes off those tinker toy words when they start hanging out with that nowhere tune. Comes on like gangbusters. Like there's some meaning in them that no way was there before. Or like they just went into some whole new karma. You can't believe they had it in them, just glomming them, parked there on the street looking like Gabriel Heater, reading his induction notice over a coast-to-coast hookup. Unreal, that Mr. B, just camping there on the ivories, all by his lonesome, making those licks talk the way they knew their way in the dark. And him, like a dropout that made out like music writing, was out to lunch and he wouldn't give it the right time of day. Gives you the creeps, just trying to figure it. What kind of number he's doing on you when he trots out that tacky bag of rubber bands and rag dolls, and it all comes out sounding like Sarah Bernhardt should live so long. Yeah, and when the 14-carat gold-plated chantuzies goose it, a couple notches like Sarah Vaughn, or even some stud like the Groner running it up those pearly pipes, maybe going like 60, and then out of nowhere, hitting the skids or floating it out front real pretty a while, just setting it up for a little light jab or a quick knee to the inner sanctum. You know you've been somewhere else, man, when they're talking to you in some heavy new language you're digging the most. Or what was that Ellington said? It don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing or something. I don't know. But it sure as hell don't mean the same old thing. Them rinky-dink noises you'd make if you mouthed them words off in a massage parlor or even the dupe debutante ball over at the PA at Ebbets Field, pitch-hitting for Gladys Gooding on opening day. Better lay off it. You'd blow the head gasket on your shiny new laugh meter, or the BMT don't go to Canarsie. Makes you sound like you guzzled a glob of Preparation H instead of your Jello, or maybe got water on the tonsils. Or like one of those borscht belt buffolas that breaks you up goofing on some crazy saga, like he's yakking some far out Eskimo lingo. Drives you nuts, cause it almost goes down like making sense, but keeps ending up with you clutching for air like you just whiffed on a 3-2 on a nickel scroogie a mile outside. No kidding. Them Eskimo type words come out like they could sound like they mean something, irregardless of you not having a clue where it's at. Beats me how you can tell for a dead cert Eskimo instead of frog jabber anyway. Or maybe this here classical dude's been laying it out straight the whole time in two-bit Eskimo, and here I thought it was just jazz. Fandangos doing radical plastic surgery on the mother tongue. Or like Hot Lips Page on Wawa Mute blowing Let a Song Go Out of My Heart like he's jiving the fuzz so the man would a tumble, whether it's heavy rank or just shooting the breeze with his horn, like back in assembly when you did Pledge of Allegiance or Columbia, the gem of the ocean, and no one in the whole PS45 could have made out the words in a book. Or like the old lush on the block, had to do an X on his welfare chit, could read his way around a liquor store faster than Albert Einstein could figure his pension. Or like all that chintzy book jive old Miss Portmore lay on us. That was Hubert Updike on the Judy Canova program. And that the cool dudes would do a dead ringer for her in the schoolyard at PT, except they just faked the words or did some naughty ones instead. Got their ass kicked good for it too, so I couldn't see much percentage in it myself. Old man Berlin, though, he must have had all that jazz cooled so he could take some regular old words you'd known all your life and make them sound like they were something you'd never heard before. Maybe that's how they came to sound so funny when you do that bit without the tunes. After you got them down in your head because they sound like music, like the meaning just took a powder and left you in the lurch with a mouthful of marbles and a jinx on your cue ball. And anytime I dig some new Berlin number, they mostly have the same words as each other, but they keep getting more to them every time they're out. Like your whole life, the same words keep meaning more things from when you were a kid, and they're all pretty much a jumble and not too different from each other. Like in kids' games, like in a My Name is Alice, where the kids just groove on saying words that sound like each other or go through the ABCs and don't really hear much of anything else. They mean. Of course, when you were growing up and heard a lot of Berlin songs and they all keep sounding more and more different than all the other words, like they'd pick up some new crud from every way they've been spoke till you spat them on a rush hour crowd like they were Marilyn Monroe at a temperance rally. And wouldn't it be too much to just like run into old Berlin out on the boulevard one fine day, just to give him five and tell him your handle's Joe Dokes? And I've always admired your compositions, Mr. Berlin, like he'd croaked already, if you would have been in the papers by now. Then I could ask him how he does it, except where would I be if he said, what did I think the words meant? The shit would have hit the fan, right? Because he'd probably clam. A deep mother like him didn't get in the chips, handing it out on the corner of Broadway and 50th. To any wise ass got the chutzpah to put the touch on him, like he's got nothing to do but kill time. Still and all, there has to be some way he does it, to put it all together like Mutt and Jeff. It still comes up smelling like roses. Well, if someone wants to get the inside track on any of that, they'll have to ask Berlin himself what he thinks about it. What it's about, you dig me? No point asking me, I just work here. Listen. You can hear an image. Or you can hear a symbol. Listen. You can retain an image, drawing to itself everything that attaches to it. Or you can metabolize an image as a symbol, absorbing it into an infinite chain of disappearing links, each a path to something else. Listen to an image of utterance, language brewing in the cauldron of composition, creating time as sound of meaning. Or listen to a symbol, language vanishing in terminal utterances, terminally delivering each its own message, evacuating itself at every tick, outflowing, interminable once-ness, evaporated in the sound of clock time passing. Listen. The capacity to give things quality and sense and resonance is what enables language and is the power to make language. Meaning is a heterogeneous metamorph of the ever-evolving sense world, now personified. Every word that deepens an object, every object that amplifies a word, every utterance in referential tones creates a metaphor. Only names and terms correctly applied must fail to describe. Listen to an image of thought presented, asking only to be received, as a heavily indexed sense of something imagined. Not to a symbol of points to be scored as for and against, or grist for a mill of doctrines and truth. No textbook need be rewritten, nor footnote obliged to acknowledge the present occasion. Somewhere, meta-bounded nowhere, there may arise a language which might be a music. A music which might be a language. I have been listening for something to speak. Listening to hear language speak. Listening to hear music speak. Listening to language. Listening to music. Listening to find a voice for myself to speak, so that I may speak to you.